the five pioneer board members to moderate and sustain the operations of the newly created Cameroon Community Media Network have been elected in a general assembly held recently at the network's headquarters in Buea. The five elected board members include Reverend Geraldine Forba as president, Reverend Sinfrid Sino as vice president, Kum Leonard as Secretary General, Mfomi Jibril Tamfu as Treasurer, and His Royal Highness Emmanuel Ndongo Molonge as Disciplinary Officer. The elections that were direct and transparent followed the election guidelines as prescribed by Article 11 of the newly adopted Articles of Association for the Cameroon Community Media Network. After her election as President of the network, Reverend Geraldine pledged on behalf of the board not to disappoint network members, calling on all to collaborate so that the network can attain set objectives, also promising to rally journalists under the banner of peace journalism.
Well, the Cameroon Community Media Network gave me this assignment today in an acclamative election. I'm very humbled. And I am happy also, because if you are in an association or among people and they see qualities of leadership in you, it gives you the singular opportunity to be happy that there is something imbibed in you. So I'm happy yet very humbled, and I pray that I'll be able to carry on the task. Well, as a journalist, all of us are journalists, and my first vision is that of peace, because there are so many journalists, there are so many organizations out there owned by journalists, but the Cameroon Community Media Network is bringing something different. And my vision is an inclusive journalism where everybody sees each other as a brother, as a sister, thereby propagating peace. So the first vision is that of imbibing the qualities of peace journalism to all journalists within Southwest and within the Northwest and the entire Cameroon, so that we can change the landscape of reporting in our media houses, so that when there is an event, we should not look at what happened, but when we are writing a paper, let us also bear in mind that our paper might have a negative consequences or effects in our society. And so it's not just about telling the story, but also looking at both sides of the story and try to bring out the peace aspects of that story.
Before the elections proper, members of the network in session critically revised the proposed articles of association that would guide the functioning of the organization of the Cameroon Community Media Network, including the network's charter and the modus operandi. Members were taken through the 16 articles of the association, point after point, the 13 subheads that describe the modus operandi, and the 10 points that make up the charter. Questions were raised by members on issues that they were not clear about. Deliberations followed on such issues, and the assembly adopted what they considered best for the network in such cases. It was after a thorough revision of all three documents that they were finally adopted by the General Assembly to be the regulatory instruments of the newly created network. The validation exercise was followed by a presentation by Alexander Vojvoda on the conception, evolution, and present context of the Cameroon Community Media Network to help put into perspective the whole idea and motivation for the existence of the network.
We just thought here, why not? When we're doing something, why do we not share our knowledge and the experience we are having here? And from this on, regular meetings came up, and with different crisis and conflict situations, the idea came, why not promote actually the idea of conflict-sensitive journalism? Why not stick to the idea that community media are a platform, are a dialogue platform in a really local context, because they can communicate in the local language, they have really deep connections to the community, the people trust you, what you're telling them. So why not stick to this de-escalation, peace, journalism approach and intensify it.
The election of board members to pilot the affairs of the network is seen by members as a positive move that will help consolidate what has been achieved, as well as move the network to fulfill set targets for all of its members.
I think the new executive that I'm put in place is quite a dynamic one, and I am expecting that they will go a long way to ensure that this network should be more dynamic to strive towards attaining its objectives. And just like we all know, it is said, united we stand, divided we fall. If media organs are coming together now to be as one, and with a vibrant ESCO put in place, we think that it will definitely go a long way to meet with the dreams and vision of.
It is worth noting, however, that before the meeting by the General Assembly to revise and adopt the Articles of Association, Charter and Modus Operandi, a committee that was formed worked on the three documents a day earlier. The committee of six members made many corrections on the draft as presented by the consultant that was hired for the preparation of the documents. This committee went through almost all the lines in the documents to shape them meet the set vision of the network and its members. The document that was finally revised and adopted by the General Assembly in its first session was a product of the committee's work a day earlier.